got shot going to work one morning at the bus stop, going to work. I was a waiter before I got shot, working at a Chinese restaurant.
And how old were you at the time?
I was 21 years old at the time.
What has life been like for you since then? I took you to the hospital and then what?
Went to the hospital, I woke up. When I woke up, I don't know if it was, if a day has passed or anything like that. Because when I wake up, they was asking me which year it was, what. And when I couldn't move, so I find out that something is wrong. The doctor come to me and was telling me that he said that I got shot. And he was asking me if I know how it happened. I tell him what I could recall. And he looked at me and told me that, asked me to move my limb and find out that I couldn't move my foot, my hand barely moving. I bring up my hand to show him that my hand moved. But I couldn't move down here. So he was telling me that something went wrong. So you have to do another x-ray to see if anything goes wrong in my spine. So when they do the x-ray, they tell me that I got a bullet lodged in my spinal cord, in my spine. So it affect me. It affect my lower limb.
How have you been coping? How do you manage?
Well, I was working to provide for myself. So after I got shot, I have to be depending on my parents before they die, because the two of them is no longer here. No, but I have to actually let them doing everything, because I couldn't even sit up. I couldn't sit up without someone holding me. So they have to be me, they have to do everything for me. It's rough. Struggle to get where I am now, that can do look something for myself, like tidy and do my, you know, maybe use my hand properly. But it wasn't easy. It isn't easy. Even now, I'm trying to live a normal life, like someone else. Know that they get up in the morning, they take a bath, and they eat breakfast and stuff like that. I'm trying to put together a bathroom, because I don't really, you know. That's the way I have to try to do things on my own, because it's expensive for me to go to someone and tell someone that I want a bathroom to make and stuff like that. So I have to be using my parents' own, and you know, but it's uncomfortable. Even to provide something to eat, I have to ask in family members to help me. Or, as you can see, sometimes a little package will come every now and then. Sometimes a package come, but I'm not asking for help from someone to be taking thing, money in the pocket to give me or anything like that. I want to even have a work that I know I can do at home, or even if it's on the road, at least it's the weekends and is there to proceed and do a normal thing without having any complication. You see, but I know a little about computer, so if someone tell me that it take that, I will do the stuff that it take to reach that limit to can provide for myself. I would try my best, if I even to go back to school, as long as the opportunity is there, I will be.
Yeah, it was a Sunday night. Yeah, and I just went, there was a domino tournament up there. And I go up there and I was sitting on the outside, waiting for my turn to come to play domino. And I come couple more persons out there and two somebody leave and leave me and the next drink come on. And then little after I just hear be a gunshot. And me get the first shot and I'm on arm here, so I cry through here, so I get the next one on my belly. I want to start run off and I get one on my back. And that one there, I drop and from there so foot them now move and I go to the hospital and do the operation and, you know. From there them tell me say like me have an L1 injury. And from there so now I get and go to Mona rehab, spend couple months there. Then after I go to Mona rehab, it took me a year to get registered in Mona rehab, you know. And from there I gradually getting better.
What was life for you before the incident?
Come on, what life was blooming for my man, you know, cause the community where we live in Augustown, you know, it's a nice community. Anything you put your head to, that you can really get out. So I mean, used to put my head to like construction work and those things, and it was really paying off. I used to employ people and all those stuff, and you know, thing was going on very good for me, you know. Cause even when I get shot, I run aside from myself, plus me up on the next side to one of my co-workers work on like one me if work with him, you know. So things was going on very good, you know, I couldn't complain, you know. When the incident happened, yeah, me and my sister and my mother and a couple good friends, yeah, rally around me. Yeah man, that really, you know, bring me down to that breaking point, you know. Otherwise from like me end up with that thing where them calling me bed sore and that stress me out till I get it, you know, I get it. My mother look at her fight and get better and thing, you know. Yeah, it was really tough. I don't tell no lies still, but as I tell you, so you can really accept the reality and say it already happened, because when you check the statistics and so much people dead around you, it still give you, they really like you glorify some people dead, but it still give you hope, like I say, you're still alive, you know. So no bother, just still go around and do whatever I want to do. Two years ago, I tile off in my kitchen, the countertop, slab it off and tile it off, tile wall, build a ramp for driving and them things there by a little assistant, like people to mix up or them to go up on a tall stool or so, and I do my thing. So I to tell them I can't do my thing. If I get even a job now, I can supervise it and see to that it done, you see me? If somebody can build a house and them know probably the material they must buy, I can give them an estimate or something like that and probably get a little money from the estimate and so, you know. Yeah, so basically all is not lost, you know. Yeah, all is not lost. All, yeah, hope is there, you know. Mm-hmm.